Hi students, good morning. Welcome back to social class. Students, how are you? I hope you all are fine and safe by the grace of God. Students, now we are learning geography part. From geography part, which lesson we are learning now? Have you remember, students? Very good. Now we are learning geography lesson 6, is it? From geography lesson 6, in which topic we learned in previous class? Have you remember, students? We learned about drainage and climate, is it? From that topic, I gave detailed question and short answers. Did you learn, students? Very good. Those who did not learn, you should learn. Okay. Students, in the beginning of this class, we can recollect few important points about previous class portion. Okay. In the previous class, first of all, we learned about drainage. Drainage, that means rivers. Rivers are the lifeline of our state, is it? Tamil Nadu has many rivers. We learned about some of the important rivers. What are the important rivers of Tamil Nadu? Have you remember, students? Very good. Kaveri, Palar, Ponniyar, Vaigai and Tamrabarani. Is it? These are the important rivers in Tamil Nadu. From here, one of the river is Perennial. Is it? Which is the river is Perennial? Very good. Tamrabarani. Tamrabarani is the Perennial river. Perennial means throughout the year that particular river has water. Okay. Then we learned about each river's where they originated, from where to where it is flowing. That all explanation we learned, is it? For example, first we learned about Kaveri, river Kaveri. River Kaveri is originated from, very good, in Karnataka, is it? In Karnataka state, but most of the areas are flowing through Tamil Nadu. River Kaveri is, most of the areas are flowing in Tamil Nadu. Then one of the important waterfalls are formed through River Kaveri, is it? In which waterfalls have you remember, students? Very good. Kakanakkal. Kakanakkal waterfalls in Thermaburi district are formed by River Kaveri, is it? Then one of the a dam was built across the River Kaveri. Important dam, that is Mettur Dam, is it? Mettur Dam, it was built across the River Kaveri. And also one of the Anaikat was built across the River Kaveri, is it? Which is the important Anaikat, students? Very good. Kallanai, is it? Kallanai is the important Anaikat. It was built across the River Kaveri, is it? Then the second one is, very good, Palar, River Palar. It is River Palar also originated in Karnataka district, but it is flowing through Tamil Nadu. That means 57% of this river is flowing through Tamil Nadu. Many tributaries are there, and also this water is used for irrigation and other domestic purposes also, is it? Then thirdly, we learned about the Tenponniyar or Pennaiyar. Okay, this river also originated in Karnataka state, but 77% of this river is flowing in Tamil Nadu, is it? 77% of this river is flowing in Tamil Nadu. Okay, then fourthly, we learned about River Vaigai. River Vaigai was originated in the Western Ghats of Tamil Nadu. Is it? River Vaigai, it is originated in the Western Ghats of Tamil Nadu. Okay. Then, this river is flowing many areas of Tamil Nadu, and this river also very useful to irrigation purposes. Is it? Then, finally, we learned about Tamrabarani, River Tamrabarani. River Tamrabarani is originated from the peaks of Podigai Hills, is it? Podigai Hills. Okay. Then, these are the important rivers we learned from previous class portion. Okay. Then, next we learned about climate, is it? Next we learned about climate. Tamil Nadu lies the south of Tropic of Cancer near equator, is it? So Tamil Nadu receive vertical temperature. So because of vertical temperature, Tamil Nadu has high temperature throughout the year. Okay. Then We learned about some of the important seasons in Tamil Nadu. What are the important seasons in Tamil Nadu, students? I told you two more important question, is it? What are the important seasons of Tamil Nadu? Winter season, summer season, southwest monsoon season and northeast monsoon season. Is it? These are the important seasons of Tamil Nadu. Then we learned about each seasons one by one. For example, first we learned about the winter season. Winter season is occur during the month of January to February. Is it? January to February. During this period, the winter temperature is 15 degrees Celsius to 25 degrees Celsius. Some of the slopes, that means hill stations areas, has 5 degrees Celsius. And also some of the valley areas like Nilgiri, 0 degrees Celsius, is it, during the winter season. Then we learned about the summer season. During the month of March to May, the summer season will occur during the month of March to May. Okay, March to May. During this period, the sun rays or falls vertically in the earth. So, during this period, we get high temperature. That means 30 degrees Celsius to more than 40 degrees Celsius temperature we are receiving. Okay, then next we learned about the southwest monsoon. Southwest monsoon during the month of June to September. Is it? During the month of June to September, southwest monsoon will occur. During this period, because of low pressure, this southwest monsoon will occur. And also, southwest monsoon during this season, the rain shadow will blow in Tamil Nadu. As a result, Tamil Nadu receives meager rainfall. That means very small rainfall. Average rainfall is 50 centimeter rainfall. We are getting only 50 centimeter rainfall. Okay, then finally we learned about northeast monsoon. Is it? During the month of October to December. Northeast monsoon occur during the month of October to December. Is it? In this season is also called retreating monsoon. That means because of northeast monsoon, it returning and flow in the southwest monsoon also. So it is also called the retreating monsoon. During this period, the tropical cyclone will occur. Most of the areas of Tamil Nadu occur cyclone. And also, the annual rainfall, that means more than 60% of rainfall we are getting through this particular season. That means in the northeast monsoon season from the month of October to December. Okay, these are the things we learned in the previous class. Okay, students, day-to-day portion you will learn. Those who did not learn, you should learn well. Okay, students, now let us come forward to today's class. Okay, now let us come forward to today's class. Today I am going to teach soils of Tamil Nadu. Today I am going to teach soils of Tamil Nadu. In the third lesson, I taught about the soils of India. Soils of India, is it? In this class, I am going to teach soils of Tamil Nadu. Okay, in this class, I am going to teach soils of Tamil Nadu. Okay, the soils in Tamil Nadu are classified into 5 types. Before that, what is mean by soil? What is soil? Soil is the uppermost layer of the land surface. Is it? Soil is the uppermost layer of the land surface. And also, there are 3 categories are there. Is it? Soil. There are 3 categories of soils are there. They are silt, sand, clay. Is it? Silt, sand, clay. In the before lessons I taught. Is it? Likewise, the soils of Tamil Nadu are classified into 5 types. They are alluvial soil, black soil, red soil, laterite soil and saline soil. Listen very careful, students. The soils in Tamil Nadu are classified into 5 types. They are alluvial soil, black soil, red soil, laterite soil and saline soil. Okay, now I am going to explain each soil one by one. The first one is alluvial soil. Okay, the first one is alluvial soil. Alluvial soils are formed by the deposition of the silt by rivers. In the previous lesson also we learned alluvial soil. It is formed by the deposition of the rivers. Okay. It is found in the river valley region. Mostly we can found alluvial soil in the river valley areas. Okay. Mainly in the coastal plains of Tamil Nadu also we can found with this alluvial soil. Okay. Generally this type of soil is found in the districts of Tanjavur, Tiruvarur, Nagapattinam, Vilupuram, Koodalur, Tirunelveli and Kanyakumari districts. These all districts are the coastal districts. These students, coastal districts, mostly the coastal districts we can found the alluvial soil, and also the river valley area. For example, in the Tanjavur, most of the rivers are flowing in Tanjavur, through Tanjavur is it. That areas also we can found the alluvial soil. Okay, then the second one is black soil. Okay, black soil are formed by the weathering of igneous rocks. Okay, it is also called Ragur soil. The black soil's other name is Ragur soil. Important one word question, book inside. Black soil's other name is Ragur soil. Okay, in this soil, the cotton grow well. Cotton or grow well in this particular soil, and also black soil are found mainly in the district of Coimbatore, Madurai, Virudhunagar, Tirunelveli and Thoothukudi. These are the district we can found black soil. Mostly in black soil the cotton were growing. Cotton cultivation was the farmers are doing. Okay, then the next one is the red soil. Red soils cover 2/3 of the total area of Tamil Nadu. In Tamil Nadu, 2/3 of the total areas are covered by red soil. Okay, then this soil are found mainly in the central district of the state. Mostly in Tamil Nadu, the central part of districts were formed by red soil. Okay, mainly we can found red soil in the district of Sivagangai and Ramanathapuram. In this red soil. Okay, then the next one is laterite soil. This soil is formed by the process of leaching. These soils are found in the many parts of Kanchipuram, Tiruvallur and Tanjavur districts. Mostly we can found in this soil in the district of Kanchipuram, Tiruvallur and Tanjavur. Okay, and also some of the mountainous regions also we can found in this soil. For example, mostly in the Nilgiri mountain regions we can found this laterite soil. Okay, then the next one is the saline soil. Mostly we can found saline soil in Vedaranyam. In the Coromandel coast areas mostly we can found, mostly in Vedaranyam we can found in the saline soil. And also the tsunami waves, because of tsunami waves it brought a lot of sand. That means in the coastal area sand were brought by the sea waves, and that particular sand was deposited located along the east coast of Tamil Nadu. That particular sand are deposited along the east coast of Tamil Nadu. Okay, this tsunami also made the coastal areas to unsuitable for cultivation. That means because of forming sand, the coastal areas is unsuitable for cultivation. We cannot cultivate any crops in the coastal regions. Okay, then the next one is soil erosion. Soil erosion. Soil is a non-renewable resource, is it? It is very difficult to replace. Once the soil want to degrade means the next new soil want to form means it is very difficult. Okay. Because of deforestation, overgrassing, urbanization, because of that the soil erosion will occur. Okay. In Tamil Nadu, the soil erosion reduces the fertility of the soil. Most of the areas get soil erosion, it reduces the fertility of the soil. Okay, it reduces the fertility of the soil. So, because of that, the agriculture were affected. Because of soil erosion, it reduces the agriculture productivity. Okay, it reduces the agricultural productivity. So, our main work is to conserve the soil. To conserve and manage the soil. Okay, then the next topic is natural vegetation. Natural vegetation refers to the forest cover. That means the forest area. Okay, in the landforms, nature of soil, temperature, rainfall, these are the major factors of natural vegetation. Natural vegetation refers to forest. Okay, forest cover. The important factors of natural vegetation are landforms, nature of soil, temperature and rainfall. Okay, then as per National Forest Policy 1988, minimum of 1/3 of total geographical area must under forest cover. That means during the forest policy 1988, it gave the details about in Tamil Nadu, 1/3 of the total areas are covered by forest area. Okay, and also the total forest cover Tamil Nadu is far lower than this. According to the Tamil Nadu state, the forest report 2017 assessment, that means 2017 assessment of forest report, it give the details about under forest in the state is 26,281 square kilometer. According to 2017's forest report, in Tamil Nadu, 26,281 square kilometers areas are covered by forest area. Okay, it which constitute 20.21% of total area. That means totally in Tamil Nadu, 20.21% of areas are covered by forest. Okay, it says 2.99% of India's forest. That means in India, 2.99% of forest areas are covered by Tamil Nadu. Okay, then the forest types in the state varies from wet evergreen to surf forest. That means evergreen forest, the surf thorny forest also covered in Tamil Nadu. Then next I am going to teach the different types of forest. Okay, the forest are broadly divided into 5 types. Okay, forest are broadly divided into 5 types. Tropical evergreen forest, mountain temperate forest, tropical deciduous forest, mangrove forest and tropical thorn forest. Okay, in Tamil Nadu, the forest are classified into 5 types. They are, the first one is tropical evergreen forest. The first one is tropical evergreen forest. Tropical evergreen forest. This forest type is found mainly in the areas of heavy rainfall. Heavy rainfall areas, mostly we can found the tropical evergreen forest. Okay, then this tropical evergreen forest is found in the upper slopes of Western Ghats, that means in the Western Ghats place of Tirunelveli, Kanyakumari, Nilgiri and Coimbatore district. In Kanyakumari, Tirunelveli, Nilgiri and Coimbatore districts, mostly we can found the tropical evergreen forest. Then mostly in the tropical evergreen forest areas are covered by some of the trees, spices, etc. For example, cinnamon, Malabar, ironwood, panasa, java, plum, jat, kindal, ayani and crab myrtle. These are the important trees in this particular forest area. Then the semi-evergreen type of forest are found in this region also. In the Eastern Ghats, semi-evergreen type of forest also covered. For example, in Servarayan, Kollimalai, Pachai Malai, these areas also have the tropical evergreen forest. Okay. Then some of the spices are there in this particular forest area, and also mahogany, monkey, teak, woolly cassia, jack and mango trees also growing in this particular forest area. We can found these all types of trees in this tropical evergreen forest. Okay. Then the second type of forest is montane temperate forest. The second type of forest is montane temperate forest. Okay. Montane temperate forest. It is found in the valleys of Anaimalai, Nilgiri and Palani Hills. We can found in this forest areas, in the areas of valleys of Anaimalai, Nilgiris and Palani Hills. Okay. It is 1000 meters altitude. Altitude means height. Okay. It is 1000 meters height of the sea level. Okay. And also this forest is also known as Cholas, Chola forest. This forest is also called Cholas. Okay. In these forest trees are very evergreen, but it is very short. Evergreen, the forest trees are very evergreen, but these trees are very short trees. Okay. Then Nilgiri Champa, Bates Litsia and Rose Apple. These are the common trees of in this particular forest. Okay. Then the third one is tropical deciduous forest. The third one is tropical deciduous forest. This type of forest lies semi-evergreen and evergreen forest. This type of forest is lies in semi-evergreen and evergreen forest. Okay. In this type forest trees are shed their leaves during dry season. That means during summer season, dry season, these particular forest trees are shed their leaves. And also these trees, these particular forest areas trees are rise up to the height of 30 meter. It grow up to the height of 30 meter. Okay. Then some of the important trees in this particular forest areas are silk cotton, kapok, kadamba, dog, teak, woman's tongue, axolotl, cerise, bamboos. These are the important trees in this particular forest area. Okay. Then this forest areas trees are mostly used for economically these particular trees are used. That means for the purpose of exporting these trees are using. Okay. Then the next one is mangroves forest. The last one, fourth one is mangrove forest. Mangrove forests are found in the coastal areas, river deltas and island areas. Okay, mostly we can found in the mangrove forest in the coastal areas, river areas, in some of the island areas we can found in this particular forest. Okay, this forest vegetation is evergreen. Okay, evergreen. It is moderate height. Okay, medium height, and it is leathery leaves. Okay, it is leathery leaves. Okay, then some of the important trees are Asiatic mangrove, white mangrove, wild jasmine, Indian pivot. These are some of the important trees in this particular forest. And also Pichavaram, Vedaranyam, Muthupat, Chatram and Thoothukudi. These are the areas we can found mostly in this particular forest. Okay, then listen students, that blue color box you listen. Pichavaram mangrove forest. Pichavaram mangrove forest. It is located near Chidambaram. The Pichavaram mangrove forest. It is located near Chidambaram, Koodalur district. It is located near Chidambaram, Koodalur district. This is the second largest mangrove forest in the world. Important one word question. The second largest mangrove forest in the world is Pichavaram mangrove forest. Pichavaram. Okay. Pichavaram mangrove forest is the second largest mangrove forest in the world. Okay. And also it is located near Chidambaram Koodalur district. It is located Chidambaram Koodalur district. And also it is covering the hectares areas of 1100 hectares. Okay, it is covered 1100 hectares. Okay, 1100 hectares. That means 11 square kilometer areas are covered by this particular mangrove forest. Okay, then the next last one is tropical thorn forest. The last one is tropical thorn forest. Thorn forest. These thorn forests are we can found in Tamil Nadu in some other areas. The low rainfall areas mostly we can found tropical thorn forest. Okay. These forests are found in the plain areas up to 400 meters altitude. Up to the height of 400 meters altitude in the plain areas we can mostly found in this type of forest. The common trees of this forest are rusty acacia, beal, neem and palm. These are the important trees in this particular forest. And serbs are the common vegetation of this type of forest. Okay, mostly we can found in this type of forest in the districts of Dharmapuri, Ramanathapuram and Virudhunagar. Dharmapuri, Ramanathapuram and Virudhunagar. Some of the interior part districts also we can found in this type of forest. Okay, then the next one is districts with prominent forest cover in Tamil Nadu. That means the prominent forests are covered in Tamil Nadu are Dharmapuri, Coimbatore, Erode, Vellore, Nilgiri and Thindukal. These districts are mostly formed by this particular forest. Okay, that area, how much square kilometers, that also given there. You should read that. Okay, then the next one is wildlife. The next one is wildlife. Animals and birds live in forest constitute the wildlife. Wildlife, that means animals and birds live in forest constitute the wildlife. The animals and birds live in forest is mentioned the wildlife. Okay. In Tamil Nadu, variety of wild animals, birds and reptiles are there. Is it in Tamil Nadu? Varieties of wild animals are there, birds are there, reptiles are there. Mostly in the hill stations are the home of elephants, bison, tiger, deer and monkey. These animals home is the hill stations. Okay, then several wildlife sanctuaries and national parks are there in Tamil Nadu. Then biosphere reserves in Tamil Nadu. There are three biosphere reserves in Tamil Nadu are there. This is very important 2-mark question. Book inside 2-mark question. Okay, students. Public exam question. Biosphere reserves in Tamil Nadu. Nilgiri Biosphere Reserve. Half of Mannar Biosphere Reserve. And Agastyar Malai Biosphere Reserve. Important 2-mark question. Okay. Nilgiri Biosphere Reserve. Gulf of Mannar Biosphere Reserve. And Agastyar Malai Biosphere Reserves. Okay, in Tamil Nadu, the state of Tamil Nadu has different varieties of animals, birds and reptiles. Because of climate, we have varieties of animals. That means we have the good climate, moderate climate, is it? So because of that, varieties of animals, birds and reptiles also there in Tamil Nadu. Okay, available resources, we are utilizing available resources to talk stop in the country, so we can conserve the forest area. Okay, individually we can achieve this goal. That means we can conserve the forest area and we can save the soil and the forest area. Okay, students, can you understand? Shall we recall the points? Students, in this class we learned about soils of Tamil Nadu and types of forest, is it? First of all, we learned about soils of Tamil Nadu. Before that, I am asking one question. Students, what is soil? That means define soil. Soil is the uppermost layer of the land surface, is it? Soil is the uppermost layer of the land surface. What are the categories of soil? Very good. Silt, sand, clay. Is it silt, sand, clay are the three categories of soil. Then first of all, we learned about different types of soil. How many types of soil in Tamil Nadu? Very good. There are five types of soil in Tamil Nadu. What are the five types of soil in Tamil Nadu, students? Excellent. Alluvial soil, black soil, red soil, laterite soil, and saline and alkaline soil. Is it? Alluvial soil. Alluvial soil was deposited by rivers. Okay. Then mainly we can found alluvial soil in the river valley areas and the coastal plains. For example, Tanjavur, Tiruvarur, Nagapattinam, Vilupuram, Koodalur, Tirunelveli. These districts mostly we can found alluvial soil. Okay. Then secondly, we learned about the black soil. Is it black soil? Black soil was formed by the weathering of igneous rocks. Is it? Weathering of rocks. And also black soil has one more name. Is it? What is the other name? Very good. Ragur soil. Is it? One word question. Ragur soil. The other name of black soil is ragur soil. Which cultivation mostly we can do in this black soil? Very good. Cotton. Okay, cotton grow well in the black soil. For example, in the district of Coimbatore, Madurai, Virudhunagar, Tirunelveli and Thoothukudi district, mostly we can found in this black soil. Then third one is the red soil. Is it? Totally in Tamil Nadu, 2/3 of the total area covered by this red soil. Is it? Mainly we can found Sivagangai and Ramanathapuram district. Mostly we can found this laterite soil. Then it is formed by the process of leaching. Is it? In the previous classes, I explained well. Is it? These all things. The next one is the saline soil. Saline, mostly we can found in this soil in the Vedaranyam. Vedaranyam area, mostly we can found, and also most of the coastal areas. For example, because of tsunami. When tsunami was happened, students? Very good. December 26, 2004. Is it? During tsunami period, the waves of seas deposited the sand along the coast of Tamil Nadu. Okay. So, the coastal areas are not suitable for cultivating any crops. Okay. Next, we learned about the natural vegetation, soil erosion. Soil erosion. Soil, it is one of the non-renewable resources, very difficult to replace. Is it? Once soil gets degraded, means it is very difficult to replace. So, we can conserve the soil. How soil erosion will occur? Because of deforestation, overgrazing, urbanization, heavy rain. Because of this time, the soil erosion will occur. Okay. Soil erosion reduces the fertility of soil. It reduces agricultural productivity, etc. So, we can conserve and manage the soil. Okay. Then finally, we learned about the natural vegetation. That means different types of forest. Is it different types of forest we land? Is it different types? How many types of forest are there in Tamil Nadu? There are five types of forest. Is it? The first one is tropical evergreen forest. The first one is tropical evergreen forest. Is it? Mostly we can found Tirunelveli, Kanyakumari, Nilgiri, Coimbatore. These are the district we can found mostly in the tropical evergreen forest. Then some of the trees are growing in this particular forest. I explained. Is it? That also you land. Then secondly, the second type is mountain temperate forest. That means mainly we can found in this forest in the the areas of Anaimalai, Nilgiri and Palani Hills, is it? Then 1000 meters height above the sea level only maximum we can found in this type of forest. Then these forests are also called Cholas, that means Chola forest. These forests are mostly called, otherwise called Chola forest. Okay, then thirdly we learned about tropical deciduous forest. Tropical deciduous forest, these forests are shed their leaves during the dry season and also it grow up to the height of 30 meter. Then some of the important trees also we learnt, important trees growing in this particular forest. It is very useful to export from other countries for domestic some of the purposes. Okay, then fourthly we learned about the mangrove forest. Mostly we can found in this forest areas, in the coastal areas, river areas and the island areas we can found in this type of forest. Okay, some of the important trees are growing here. Then some of the main areas, then Pichavaram, Vedaranyam, Muthuppattu, Chatram, Thoothukudi, these are the important places we can found the mangrove forest. Okay, then we learned one important UNBAT question, is it? Have you remember, students, which is the second largest mangrove forest in the world? Very good, Pichavaram mangrove forest, is it? Pichavaram mangrove forest, where it is located? Very good, Sidambaram, Koodalur district. Okay, Sidambaram, Koodalur district. Totally 1100 hectares areas are covered by this Pichavaram mangrove forest. Okay, then finally we learned about the tropical thorn forest. Is it the last type is the tropical thorn forest. In Tamil Nadu, most of the areas we can found in this forest, mainly in the low rainfall areas we can found in this type of forest. Many trees and shrubs are growing in this particular forest. Mainly we can found in the district of Dharmapuri, Ramanathapuram, Virudhunagar areas we can mostly found in this type of forest. Okay, then finally we learned about the wildlife. Is it wildlife? Animals and birds live in the forest constitute the wildlife. Is it animals and forest live in the forest? It mentions the wildlife. Tamil Nadu has variety of wild animals, birds and reptiles. Is it Tamil Nadu has variety of wild animals, birds and reptiles. And also in the hill areas is the home of some of the animals also. Okay, then finally we learned about the biosphere resource in Tamil Nadu. Biosphere resource in Tamil Nadu, that means Nilgiri biosphere resource, Gulf of Mannar biosphere resource and Agastyar Malai biosphere resource. It is one of the important 2-mark question, is it, students? These all things we learned about in this class, students. Now I am going to mark and give the question answer. The continuation of this lesson I will teach the next class. Okay, students, now Allah take a book, turn page number 217, turn page number 217, Roman number 6, distinguish between, only one question is there, is it Tamirabharani and Kaveri? Refer the guide. Okay, Tamirabharani and Kaveri, refer the guide. Then Roman number 8, answer in paragraph. First two questions already I gave. The third question you will mark now. Third question, explain the characteristics, features of summer and winter season of Tamil Nadu. Answer is page number 208 and 209, 208 and 209. Winter season heading fully, summer season heading fully. Page number 208 and 209, winter season fully, summer season fully. Okay, then the fourth question, bring out the types and distribution of soils in Tamil Nadu. Answer is page number 209 and 210. 209 and 210, soils of Tamil Nadu heading starting to the next page up to saline soil. Up to saline soil, that means that paragraph fully, cultivation to a considerable extent, up to extent. Okay, mark it. Then the continuation of this lesson and remaining question answers I will teach the next class. Okay, students, these question answers you will learn well. Okay, thank you.